Capturing plastic really did something. Seeing the system out there, seeing the plastic being caught, seeing something that works, that performs like expected, builds confidence in what we're doing and that we're on the right track at this moment.
You see it?
Yeah!
Wow!
Whoa! A huge amount of plastic!
Here, it's all tiny particles also.
Yeah, FRC, transport, go ahead.
We choke the majority of the plastic. We'll start with the operation to get it on board. We proved that our methodology of cleaning is actually feasible. We have a speed difference with the plastic and we were accumulating plastic.
During this mission, we actually had an independent system in the water that caught plastic by itself and retained it, and we could harvest this plastic. So the future is bright.
This was totally new, and I think we have achieved a lot. And I believe in this one.
Yeah, Boyang always thinks about improving and always asks questions. But I think for now, he would be silent for a bit and just enjoy the moment.
It was a really important moment. It was the moment that we went from really just a promise to, okay, we can collect plastic in the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, and it can be done by a system by itself, not, you know, dragged by a ship or something. It was really just our cleanup system autonomously collecting plastic.
This is one big bag per day, per system, and it's a tiny system. Imagine what we can do when we have 60 systems which are at least 3 to 4 times as large as this one. That boils down to 4 big bags per day per system, so that in total is it 240 big bags of plastic per day.
For the cleanup to happen, it's not enough to have a technical solution that works, but we also need a solution to the financial challenge, how to keep the cleanup operation going. Because, of course, once the systems are out there, if there's not some kind of model to keep it going financially, you know, it's not going to happen. And we believe the answer to this question lies in the plastic that we take out of the ocean. Because the idea is to take that plastic, to recycle it into beautiful, sustainable products, and with that, fund the continuation of the cleanup. Of course, we're a non-profit, you know, nobody's going to make any money with this. It's just about continuing the cleanup. So the material we collect is complete garbage. It's been in the ocean for decades, sometimes up to 50 years. It's degraded, it has salt on it, there's algae on it, it's really stinky and dirty and total mess. So I think it's really going to be special to have something made from this material, because it's not just any plastic, it's plastic from the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. It's like the, you know, the difference between a normal rock and a rock from the moon. I mean, it's still rock, but it has this story behind it. So when we say these products are made from ocean plastic, what we mean is that the plastic is actually coming from the ocean. Because right now the definition of ocean plastic is really shady. It could come from anywhere. It's defined as plastic collected near the ocean. But we really want to bring the truth to the market. And we really want to guarantee to the people that support us that this plastic is coming from the Great Pacific Garbage Patch.
We are tagging the bags of plastic that has been filled during trip one, so it can be certified that it comes from the Pacific. And for that, we need like a real chain of batch number.
So we've been collaborating with DNVGL to be able to certify plastic that's actually coming from the oceans. So they keep track of the plastic through the whole chain, from it being collected all the way to it being turned into products, and every step in between is being tracked to ensure that we can really promise that this material has come from the Great Pacific Garbage Patch.